Let me ask you something. Is it difficult when you are talking with people? I mean, whether it's friends or parents of friends that look at you as, hey, you're a sellout. What are you doing? You know, what are you doing emboldening these who they call white supremacists? I mean, I was attacked on Twitter yesterday saying that just because I did not support them kneeling, that I may be. They actually called me the suspected of white supremacy because of my position against the NFL. Yeah. I mean, it's gotten nutty out there. Must be hard for you.
Yeah, I completely agree with you and what you're saying. The fact of the matter is, as a big, you know, black boy, the last thing I'm going to be doing is supporting white supremacists and endorsing white supremacy. I've got to tell you that if you disagree with the fact that these people are kneeling in the NFL, you're not endorsing white supremacy. What you're doing is believing that people's sacrifices should be respected in this country. The thing is that the constant victimization of the left is that everything that everyone does is somehow bigoted or racist or white supremacy if they disagree with you is completely insane. Have an argument with me on the merits of our disagreement. Let's talk about the issue. There's no necessity to call me a white supremacist or a bigot because I'm saying something that hurts your feelings, because guess what? Facts don't care about your feelings, so why should I?
Yeah, Pam in Eatontown, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
I have to agree with you. We've definitely lost respect for humankind, and I want to remind you, I'm not going to call you a bigot. I love you to death.
Thank you so much, Pam.
He's not running this country. Roger Goodell's not running this country. National Football League is not running this country. Who else did you mention? None of them are running this country. Until we start with unity at the top, you're not going to get it anywhere else. Irrespective of who you voted for, people have got to start respecting people. And the gentleman that said that there's more black-on-black crime, hey, throw that in the garbage. How about you take that venom and devote it to making New Jersey a better place so that some of the corruption in the political arena doesn't permeate down, so that the only way that people can survive, black, white, Jewish, Italian, whoever you are, can make it.
Pam, you have said a mouthful. I'm with you 100%. Look at the real situation going on in places like Camden, places like Newark. You want to talk about this real oppression out there. When I think about civil rights, how about the right of a family to want to be able to get their kids off to school without fear of a drug gang or a shootout? You know, how about the fact that still in Newark, you got one out of four kids still don't get through and graduate high school? I mean, the economic opportunity that is lacking in so many of our cities, these are things that people should be upset about, and they are. And I'll tell you another thing, Pam. I don't even mind like the whole Kaepernick thing and everything. I don't care. You got a right to protest wherever you want.
I don't care about his knees. Yeah. I don't care what he believes in, but I'm going to tell you that at the top, I don't care who you voted for.
Yeah.
I don't care who you believe in. If you don't start realizing that, I don't care who it is, you've got to respect people.
I agree.
They don't want to salute the flag. You don't want to watch football. Don't watch it.
Right.
Do something. Go out and volunteer.
I am Pam.